You won't disobey him. You won't go astray. And even if you do, because you are not perfect, you will repent. You will repent. But do not think that your repentance is what is saving you. Like, it's not what is keeping you safe. No. Because your repentance is something you're doing of your own accord, just to show God that you love him. So you repent because you truly don't want to sin. You also hate sin like God sin. So anything you do, you repent of it very fast, so that you can remain spiritually clean. You keep on repenting. But that has nothing to do with your salvation at all. You are saved because you are saved by grace, because of the faith you have in Jesus. You are not saved because you repented. You are saved because of your faith, and it's by God's grace. So through that faith, you are saved by his grace. So if you do anything, if you think you have to keep praying to repent, or you have to do this to repent, or you have to give out to charity to keep your salvation, you are doing works. What the Bible defines as works. And God hates that, because if you think you cannot earn your way into heaven, you cannot. So all these people that justify themselves thinking, you know, yes, so they give out to charity, they think they are good people because they don't kill anybody, they don't do this, they don't do that. But if they don't have faith, they are not going to enter heaven, because they are not saved. And it's only those that are saved that are going to enter heaven. It's as simple as that. You know, because your belief in Jesus Christ is what saves you. And that belief and that faith is accounted to you for righteousness, because no one is righteous. And because Jesus Christ is the only one that's righteous, once you believe on him, his righteousness is imputed unto us. So we are righteous in Christ Jesus. It's very important to remember that, my brothers and sisters. No one is righteous. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So there is nothing you can do. Don't let anybody tell you, you have to keep praying. Yes, you have to do all this, but it's not by doing all these things that you are saved. You do all this because you are glorifying God. You know, we are made to glorify God. We are made to worship God. So it is normal and appropriate that we do all these things, that we worship God and we pray to God. Because when we pray to God, that's how we speak to God. You know, God is a spirit. So in prayer, our spirit aligns with his own spirit, and we speak to God. And God answers us in his word, and he answers us through situations or circumstances or through other people. He uses anything because he's God. He can use anything to answer you. But God also speaks to us. A lot of people find it so hard to believe that God speaks to his children. Why? Why? God is not an arrogant God. He's a loving God. Why is it so hard to believe that God speaks to his children? He speaks to us in many ways. Some people have limited him to just speaking through his word. Yes, God speaks through his word. But he speaks through people. For instance, through prophets, through simple people, simple believers. He speaks to people through visions, through dreams, through circumstances. Something might happen in your life that, you know, it is God that is doing it. God is telling you something in that situation. So many ways, you cannot put God in a box and say, God only speaks to us in the Bible. So if somebody should come and tell you, God gave me this revelation through a dream, and because God didn't give you that revelation, he gave it to someone else, you become envious and, you know, prideful and start thinking, no, God is a lie. God never told you, gave me that revelation, because it's not in his word. You're deceiving yourself, because you're not God. God is the only one that has the authority to reveal things and to give people more understanding through anything else he chooses, whether it's through people or through situations. So, it is very important that we remain humble, because I've seen in my walk with Christ, and even with other people, that those people that are always humble, they don't assume to know everything. They teach people whatever they understand, and they are open to being taught. They are open to correction. You know, because each person has different gifts. The body of Christ has different gifts, right? Each member. But it's all to edify the body of Christ. It is all so that the body of Christ will be perfect. We can be perfect, you know, and made righteous in Christ Jesus. So any gift anybody has is to share and help people, so that everybody will be aware that this is how God is, and this is what God is saying, this is what God, you know, this is what God is doing. And it will help us be better people and draw closer to God. So we should not envy anybody. If people have gifts of prophecy, we should not envy them. If people have gifts of insight, we should not envy them. If people have gifts of teaching, gifts of interpreting, gifts of tongues, we should not envy anybody, because all is from God. We should give all God all the glory. Humble ourselves and learn from these people. And God has given us discernment to know that anything that is not from, that is not what He said, that doesn't correspond, if it contradicts His word, because any revelation we have will not contradict His word. So if anything anybody says contradicts what God says in the word, it is false. So that's how we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error.